In this training video, I will show you the features that are specific to the i3TOUCH EX series. When setting up the EX, you can choose to either install the Biz Studio or the Edu Studio. The Edu Studio looks like this, and the Biz Studio like this. From the main screen, you can access the different features. For Whiteboard and Present, we have made dedicated training videos, so check those out if you want to know more about that. What else is on the main screen? There's the time, browser, files, documents, and even more possibilities, the button to access the settings, and the hamburger menu. No matter what feature you are in, for example, the whiteboard, if you want to return to the main screen, just use the home button from the hamburger menu. What else is in the hamburger menu? Quick access to the whiteboard present and annotate features, a button to switch the input source, and the possibility to adjust the volume. Pens tend to get lost in an office environment. That's why not only did we provide two pens with this EX screen, but we also made integrated magnetic pen holders. So hopefully, you will never lose a pen ever again. Another cool feature of the pen is that it automatically starts writing. So ink is activated automatically and your finger functions as an eraser. Also, the back of the pen is an eraser. All this results in a natural writing experience. A completely new feature is the multifunction button. As the name says, this button can have multiple functions. You can choose yourself how you want the button to behave, and I'm showing you the example of freeze frame. With my phone, I am casting to the screen. So what happens on my phone happens on the screen. But let's imagine I want to show another picture, but I don't want the audience to see what other pictures there are on my phone. I just freeze the frame. I push the button. Then I go browse into my phone until I have the right photo and I can start casting again. Unfreeze the frame, and there we go. We can show other pictures while we have the privacy of not showing what's happening on our own device. Changing the behavior of the button takes place in the settings. So let's go to the settings, scroll down until we are under personal other settings, and then you see the possibilities for the button. The different actions you can choose for the button are to switch to a certain video input source, to freeze the image as I just showed you. It can work to open the task view in Windows. It's the same as what happens when you press Alt plus Tab on your Windows computer. You can assign a predefined function key in Windows to it. For example, F5 for starting the presentation in PowerPoint. Or you can use it to make a screen capture. Let me show you how the Windows function key works. I choose Windows function key, I put it on F5, then I switch to the computer I've connected to the screen, and we are in PowerPoint. Let's say we want to start the presentation, so F5 in PowerPoint starts a presentation. I press the multifunction button, and there we go, starting the presentation. Another new feature is the one cable connection. With just one USB-C cable, you can connect your device. It will charge your device through the USB-C, it will transfer images at 4K, and it will transfer sound. The fact that you use a cable means that you don't need to log in, you don't need a Wi-Fi network, you don't need passwords, you don't need to install software, so that makes it very secure for you to work with. We designed the settings menu to be as straightforward as possible. So have a look Go through the different items and you'll find everything you need concerning settings. Wi-Fi, apps, display sound, security, date and time, and so on. That's it for this video. Don't forget, there's also a manual available with clarifying explanations and step-by-step print screens. But if you do have further questions, don't hesitate to contact us.